Well, obviously the question of what happens to someone between death, bodily death, and the general resurrection was an incredibly important issue between Protestants and Catholics because of the issue of purgatory. And Luther, at least for part of his time, talked about soul sleep. And then Calvin, on the other side, made the conscious awareness of God, of those who are saved during this intermediate state, a doctrinal issue. And then the Catholic Church did a little bit later at the Council of Trent. And a lot of scholars argue from really fuzzy things that we can know about eschatological issues backwards to more, if I may use the word, substantial issues, like whether there's a substantial soul or not. But if you think that there must be conscious awareness of God between death and resurrection, and if you think that you can meaningfully talk about the progression of time after a person dies and after the person is with God, then you pretty much need to have some substantial entity to hang that consciousness on. And so that's why most of the people who object to physicalism strenuously are Calvinists. But then there are also the Catholics. And a snide remark is, nobody's ever said Calvin was infallible.
Okay.
And the Catholic Church says it can never go wrong, so they can never take back anything that they've said. But the Protestants are always supposed to be semper reformanda. So there's always...
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you for that.
So the Calvinists ought to get off my back.
Okay, that's how I see it. Okay.